In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate Transfiguration of the Lord, this feast. But this event is not just a transfiguration of Jesus. The second reading from the letter of St. Paul reminds us of our own transfiguration. So this celebration would tell us, let us not settle for less, because God is preparing something better and even the best for each one of us. But for many times that we fail to appreciate God's greatness and abundance of blessings, we acknowledge our sins, be sorry for them, then we ask for the mercy of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest. God, who in the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son, confirmed the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers, and wonderfully prefigured our full adoption to sonship So grant, we pray, to your servants that listening to the voice of your beloved Son, we may merit to become co-heirs with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was bright as snow, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire, with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The Lord is
King, let the earth rejoice. Let the many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice. All peoples see his glory. Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods. The second reading taken from the second letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But we had been eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it. As to a lamp shining in a dark place, until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of the Lord. Let us all stand to honor the Holy Gospel. is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, This is my beloved Son. Listen to him. Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord. Two things with regards to this account of the transfiguration of Jesus. In itself, the account itself, before we look at the whole picture of the account of this transfiguration, what happened is that Jesus went to a high mountain. It's just not a mountain, but a high, mataas. So hindi lahog-lahog, nataklaro nila. And what would they do there? They would play, they would eat, they would sleep, they would go there to pray. Remember the Gospel of Luke, Jesus would regularly go to an isolated place, especially on a mountain, to pray by himself. So he took this tree with him on a high mountain to pray. And there, while praying, the transfiguration happened. It's not while eating, it's not while sleeping, it's not while talking, conversing, or other things, but while praying, this transfiguration, nagbalhin ang dagway niya, nagkambyo ang dagway niya, samtang nagapangamuyo siya, mas matahom ilungguhon ta. And this is not new. This is not something weird. Because through prayer, ang tutuod niya pangamuyo leads one to an inner sense, a deep sense of serenity and tranquility. And it affects, because of that inner sense of tranquility and serenity, kalinong, mayara sa nga katauhay, gado na hauasan siya sa kabuhi, nagmag-an kabuhi niya sa pangamuyo. In effect, it changes your aura. Externally, may makita nga may pagbago sa tao. It even changes your demeanor and attitude. So, hindi niya bago, hindi niya makatilngalahan. Sa mga tao, nga pangamuyo, tuntuod ha, tuntuod ginya, makita nimo ining transfiguration. Because transfiguration happens from within, going out. from within going out. So that inner peace, that deep sense of serenity from within, it goes out and it shows to people outside. May makita sila. So usually, as I've said just last week, about the also the experience of Moses, ga-change ang aura sang tao. So this is not new. This is not strange. Because there are people in our own history, church history, we call them mystics. And even until now, contemporary, prayerful people, mabatsyagan mo gid ang sense ng ila aura. Lain. Lain sa nagaprotiko lang. Nga wala man mismo sa ito nga itong personal relationship with God or profession of faith as mentioned. Yesterday, Peter professed that faith. He was professing his own personal relation with God. Puro tikol, hindi ka makita. You will never see the demeanor, the attitude, or the aura that there is a sense of serenity and peace from God. That's why the first reading tells us that the Son of Man, prefiguring the coming Messiah, the Anointed, the Christ, is face to face with the Ancient One. And the Ancient One was giving the Son of Man glory, honor, and power. And as it said, this things given to the Son of Man, the Son of Man will be responsible to confer it to those followers. Amunisin ko gina sa beginning sang misa, something best gina-prepare sang Diyos sa aton, but we settle for less. Okay naman na siguro nga mapatawad ko, mapaga lang ko sa ano ah, sa bi lang sang purgatorio, okay na na. Pakasala lang ang pakasala. Okay lang na siguro kung may bakabit, gamot, matandutay nga no. We settle for less. The promise in today's first reading, and it's followed up by the letter of Peter, I correct myself, from the letter of Peter, the promise, i-confer na sa mga followers ang nabato ni Jesus, ang Bisaya, ipasaya man sa mga followers, glory and honor. O ginahambal, this follow up. So ihatag na sa imo. So katahom kaayo. That glory, that glorious event, the transfiguration of Jesus, ihatag mo na sa imo. Promise na siya. I-confer na siya. So don't settle for less. Don't settle for less. The best is yet to come. So when we go back to Jesus' experience of praying, and in prayer, the transfiguration happened, this too would also happen to us when we go into our own prayer life. Importante ni sa aton. Transfiguration happens during prayer time, in our prayer life, interior life, because it happens from within. Gasugod sa sulod. So how? Remember, Jesus was praying, conversing with God the Father, but not only with God the Father. The mentioning of two great persons or personalities in the Old Testament, Moses and Elijah. Okay. Moses, he represents the law. He was a lawgiver. Elijah represents the prophets. The Hebrew scriptures, wala man sila yung gospel. So the Hebrew scriptures, sa mga Hudiyo, ang ila scriptures is law and prophet. Dua. In other words, my difference, if ever Jesus was conversing not only with the Father during the transfiguration event, but with Moses and Elijah, it means that part of his prayer life is reading the scriptures and reflecting on it. Oh, hari na. So hindi lang niya conversation for the coming passion and death of Jesus and resurrection, but parts ang kabuhi niya, mga muyo sa gabasa Biblia, gabasang pulong sa Diyos, kagapamalandong siya. Oh, part of it. The Word of God is part of his prayer life. Because conversing with Elijah and Moses means that you are reading the scriptures, the Old Testament, law and prophets, and figuratively, sa mga Hudiyo, they would say, you are communicating, talking, conversing with Moses and Elijah. Means that you are reading, reflecting the Word of God. And that is also prayer. Later on, the Christian communities absorbed it, and during the monastic time, they would call this praying with the scriptures as lectio divina. Steps in developing relationship with God through the Word of God, the written Word of God. The lectio, oratio, lectio, meditatio, oratio, contemplatio. You will be transfigured. You will be transfigured. Your demeanor and attitude, even the sense of serenity and peace, all this would come into you. Encountering God through the written Word of God. So the complete image of the written Word of God and the Word made flesh in the Transfiguration. Dua. So if we pray, we read and reflect and try to absorb the Word of God, the written, we become the Word made flesh. Amo na katahum. Katahum gali kaayo. Ang pulong nga nasulat, kung ipangabuhi mo, you become the Word made flesh like Jesus Christ. So beautiful. The written Word and the Word made flesh meeting in the Transfiguration. Written Word plus Word made flesh is Transfiguration. And not only that, in the Transfiguration event, there is this cloud. Ang panganod is very important. That cloud that hovered, and they were not able to see anything. Because before this, there was this profession of Peter, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And then after that, there is that Transfiguration event. Then after that, the impending, the coming death, passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Ginsandwich ang Transfiguration. Because the apostles were so down in life. Damos na batian mga batikos against Jesus. Damos na batian mga those people against Jesus. Kag hindi na malayo, may suffering, kag passion siya. So they were so down, so dark ang ilang life. They were hopeless. So the Transfiguration is an event that gives them, the hopeless people, those people about to give up, when they encounter the dark clouds of life, to give them encouragement and hope, to restore that joy in them. Yes, dark clouds in life would come. It is part of the cycle of life. But remember, it will simply come and go. It will not stay forever. There would always be a light. That's why in today's second reading from the letter of Peter, sinabi niya, we need a light, an encouragement, an inspiration whenever we go through the dark clouds of life. But when the light comes, you don't need any more light, kay sanag naman. Subong gusto mo pa plus light, kasanag naman. Pero kung gabi, we need a light. So when we go through the dark nights of life, through the dark clouds of life, we need something that we can hold on to keep us continuing to go on until the light of life would come. The cycle of life, there is darkness, there is light. Something to hold on when we are in the dark clouds of life. And what is that? The Word of God. Prayer. Prayer is our light in the midst of darkness. Amula ng aton kapawa sa tunga sa mga kadulong sa kabuhi natin, makapyutan natin until we come to the morning star mentioned by Peter in today's second reading. Mag-abot na ng bituon sang aga, kay ano pa na, bi, sandag na kaayo. It will come, that light, but from the moment that we are still traveling in this world, journeys the world, darkness again and again would come. So keep on praying and hold on to your prayer life. Hold on to your interior life. Hold on to your contemplation and hold on to the meditation every day. That is your light to keep you going in life, because you'll encounter dark clouds like the cloud that covered Peter, James, and John, and they saw nothing. Hinadlukan sila. But remember, my dear friends, in every dark cloud, there will always be a light. Or if we put it into our own personal experiences now, in every crisis, there is a blessing. When that dark cloud covered Peter, James, and John, it's so dark that they could not see anything. It's unknowing. Wala kakabalo kung ano matabo sa imo. Kay kadulong. Pero there is a blessing. They heard the voice of the Father. In every dark cloud, there is always a light. In every crisis, there is always a blessing. And you know, this transfiguration event happens in moments of crisis. Transformation, transfiguration happens in moments of crisis, when we are at the end of our resources, at our limit. Jesus was. Because he was telling this impending coming passion death. Transfiguration happens in that moment. A light in the midst of darkness. A blessing in the midst of crisis. And I would like to share with you, as I mentioned yesterday, the Spanish Carmelite mystic John of the Cross. Because he has his own experience of this cloud, dark cloud, but he calls it dark night of the soul. And he has a poem, so beautiful ang poem ni John of the Cross. He was talking about this dark cloud, and he calls this ecstasy. To be in darkness, to be in crisis, ecstasy. Oh, nanamian ka na. Gina-look forward mo nga may problema ka, nasadyahan ka, wala ta na gani, gina-pray ta gani, Lord, kuha ang problema ko. Pero kay John of the Cross, yeah, he looks at this as an ecstasy. The unknowing, the dark cloud, the dark night of the soul is an ecstasy. So I would like to share with you siling a short poem, stanza from concerning ecstasy, siling ni St. John of the Cross. I entered into a knowing, yet when I saw myself there, without knowing where I was, I understood great things. You see, in every darkness there is light. In every crisis there is a blessing. John of the Cross saw something, great things in the unknowing. What a beautiful experience. I continue, and he said, I shall not say what I felt, for I remained in unknowing, transcending all knowledge. Through this experience of John of the Cross, he saw even better and greater blessings that he never encountered in life. Because of this dark night of the soul, because of this what we call unknowing. And you know, my dear friends, another writer said, it is in the negativity, negativa, in what we go through in life, darkness, difficulties, trials, tribulations, wherein God will pour blessings on our emptiness. In moments of crisis, when we are at our limit, when we are at the end of our rope, the end of our resources, we say, wala na gid kuya, wala na gid kuya. There, God will pour in an empty soul abundant blessings. So this transfiguration event is not just for Jesus, but for all of us every day going through difficulties in life. This transfiguration should give us a preview of what God will give to us someday. Transfiguration. But while we are journeying in this world, God continues to pour abundant blessings in our empty soul every day. But not in good times, but most when we go through dark times, moments of crisis, when we are at our limit and at the end of our rope or at the end of our resources, abundant blessings come. The Lord's transfiguration on the mountain revealed His divine glory and confirmed the mystery of faith by the witness of the chosen witnesses. Let us pray that we may listen to the voice of God's beloved Son. Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
May the mystery of the transfiguration remove the scandal of the cross through the revelation of Christ's glory, we pray.
Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
May we listen to the voice of Christ who declares that He must first suffer many things before He enters into His glory, we pray.
Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
May the transfigured Christ inspire us to rise from fear, anxiety, and despair, and transform us into people of courage, hope, and love, we pray.
Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
That amidst the sorrows, pains, and discomfort of life, we may wait with patience and hope for our full revelation as children of God in Christ, we pray.
Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
May our lowly and mortal bodies be clothed someday with immortality by Christ's victory over death, we pray.
Lord, transform us into the likeness of Your Son.
Lord God, may the transfiguration of Your Son raise our mind and hearts to the heavenly realities, so that we may someday share His glory in Your kingdom. Blessed are You, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received. the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, it will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, that the grace and glory of his name are our good.
Sanctify, O Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son, and by his radiant splendor cleanse us from the stains of sin through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. And Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he revealed his glory in the presence of the chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form, which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how in the body of the whole church is to be fulfilled what so wonderfully shone forth first in its head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for For this, the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins, do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Also remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her most chaste spouse, the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Sebastian, Saint Zelie and Louis Martin, Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, who sent your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I leave you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with yours.
Offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are invited to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy should enter under my roof. Only say the word, my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Let us pray. May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you willed to make manifest in his glory and glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Urace parata on the threat from COVID-19.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cure for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. May the outpouring of your blessings on the 75th year foundation anniversary of Carmel obtain for the human family the healing graces and strength of faith so needed, and that a renewal of relationship with God through prayer change our hearts and lives for the better. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen. Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Sebastian.
Pray for us.
Saint Rob.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And
God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass ended, go glorify the Lord by your life.
And